Good morning, students. Let's start with the revision. I have written these questions from factorization chapter. First, find the GCF of these three terms. GCF means greatest common factor, or you can say HCF, highest common factor. So find out the common factor from these three terms. Second question is of factorize. Make the factors of all these terms, divide them into different brackets. First question, bolo answer. GCF, greatest common factor. In sab mein factor kaun sa common hai? You have to write the number that divides all the, it's not XY. It's 9, 9XY. Yes. लगाने हैं 9XY. वेरिएबल क्यों नहीं लगाने? Yes, greatest common factor of this first question is 9XY. 9XY divides all the three numbers, and we don't have any other number greater than 9XY which divide all three numbers. Next is factorize. 9X minus 18X square. Guess anyone who will tell me the answer? Yes, Panika, Raman. Ashpreet, Laksh, Shivraj,
yes, ma'am, 3X in the bracket 3 minus 9X.
Yes, yes, 3X
in the bracket 3 minus 9X.
No, no, it's not correct.
Ma'am, 9X in the bracket 1 minus 2X.
Yes. Take 9X common. 9X is the GCF, greatest common factor. Take 9X common. After taking 9X common, you are left with 1 minus 2X. Take 9X common. After taking 9X common, you are left with 1 minus 2X inside the bracket. So these are the two factors. Yes. In the next question, four terms are there. You have to take common from the first two terms, then from the last two terms. Take X common from the first two terms, and minus 5 common from the last two terms. So answer is yes, Aparan. Aparan. Only 3 students are responding. What about the others? Only these 3 students will give the exam. Yes, Panika.
X plus Y, X minus 5.
Take X common. When you take X common from the first two numbers, that will give you, when you take X common, you are left with X plus Y. When you take minus 5 common, you are left with again X plus Y. So take X plus Y common. From here, you will have X. After taking X plus Y common, you are left with minus 5. So these are the two factors of this question. Check your answer, X plus Y and X minus 5. Start next question. 9X square minus 1. 9 and 1 both are perfect square numbers. So in case of perfect square number, you can apply the identity. This can be written as 3X whole square minus 1 square. A square minus B square, A plus B, A minus B. 3x minus 1, 3x plus 1. Start the next question. Again, 4 terms are there. Take common from the first two terms, then from the last two terms, and make sure that you are having same factors inside the bracket. Yes, in this fourth part, you will take x common. You will take X common, that is Y minus 1. From here, you will take minus 1 common, Y minus 1. So answer is Y minus 1, X minus 1. Answer is X minus 1, Y minus 1. These are the two factors. Yes, in the last question, you can see that 4 is a perfect square, but 3 is not a perfect square. So what you will do? Middle term splitting. You will do middle term splitting. This question cannot be solved with the identity. So multiply first term with the last term. 4 threes are 12. And factors of 12 are 6 twos are 12. And 6 plus 2 will give you 8. Replace this 8a with 6a and 2a. 8a can be written as 6a minus 6a minus 2a. Again, this question will be converted to 4 terms. Take common from the first two terms, then from the last two terms. Hurry up, solve this. Hurry up, hurry up. Take 2a common, 2a minus 3. Take minus 1 common, 2a minus 3. So this is 2a minus 3 and next is 2a minus 1. Check your answer, hurry up. Minus common from the last two terms. 2a minus 1, 3a minus 2a minus 3. Start next question, write down the number of edges for each of the following 4 parts. Hurry up. Yes, number of edges for the cube is 12. Take your answer. Rectangular pyramid is like this. So it's 8. Answer of this is 8. Edges for the rectangular pyramid is 8. In triangular prism, we will draw a triangle, we will join the corresponding vertices. So this is 9. Tetrahedron is another name of triangular pyramid, and triangular pyramid has 6 edges. So this is your triangular pyramid. When all the faces are equilateral triangle, then triangular pyramid is called tetrahedron. So it has 6 edges. Draw triangular pyramid, draw triangular prism. This I've already drawn here. This is your triangular pyramid, this is your triangular prism. Write the faces, vertices and edges for the following. Yes, this is the general formula for prism and pyramid, that is in term of n. If you have triangular pyramid, then you will put the value of n as 3. If it is square pyramid, then you will put n is equal to 4. If you are talking about pentagonal pyramid, then you will put n is equal to 5. In case of prism, if triangular prism is there, triangle has 3 sides, so you will put 3 here. If it is square prism, square has 4 sides, so you will put 4 here. Pentagonal prism, pentagon has 5 sides here, so you will put 5 here. So 5 plus 2, 7. Formula. You have to learn this formula. It is not given in your book. You can use it directly, learn this, and you can just put the value of n as the number of sides. Yes, find the central angle for each of the following. You all know that central angle is to be found by making the total of this number. First central angle will be given by 36 upon total into 360. Actually, we are dividing 360 degree into different type of crops. So you will divide each number and multiply with the 360 degree angle. That will divide each part and that will give you corresponding degree for the each part. Make the total of this, and the first central angle will be 36 upon total into 360. Total is 2nd central angle is 24 upon 160 into 360. 3rd is 28 upon 160 into 360. So find the central angle for each of the following. In all the angles, this 360 upon 160 is common. Cancel it out. 4 nines are 4 fours. So 9 by 4 is common in all the numbers. So need not to multiply each number with 360 by 160. You will multiply each number 24 by 9 with 4, 9 by 4, 28 with 9 by 4, then 40 with 9 by 4, then 32 with 9 by 4. So कर लो, टाइम वेस्ट होगा। कटिंग कर, कटिंग करनी है तो एक बार कर ली, बार बार क्यों करनी है? दैट विल वेस्ट योर टाइम। सो इट विल बी 9 9s are 81 degrees. सो फर्स्ट एंगल इज योर 81 degree, सेकेंड इज 63 degree, देन 90 degree, then next is 72 degree. So these are the corresponding degrees that you will draw in your pie chart. So these all are called central angles. Now start the next question. Find the probability for each of the following. A dice is thrown. Yes. Probability of the prime number. In case of a dice, we have 6 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and these 6 numbers are called the sample space. So total outcomes are 6 here. Probability of prime number, out of these 6 prime numbers, we have 3 prime number, 2, 3, and 5. So we have 3 prime numbers. So your probability is 3/6. That is 1/2. One more thing, before starting, you will write the formula of probability, number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Next is not a prime number. When you leave these prime numbers, the remaining are non-prime number, that is again 3/6, 1/2. Next is a number greater than 4. A number greater than 4 will be 5 and 6. 2/6, that is 1/3. Next is even number. Out of these 6 number, 2, 4, and 6 are even number, that is 3/6, again 1/2. It's compulsory to make the cancellation if it can happen. Odd number is 1, 3, 5, that is again 3/6, neither prime nor composite. You have to decide the number which is neither prime nor composite. 1. 1 is neither prime nor composite. So answer is 1/6. So probability of 1 is 1/6. Yes, plot these numbers, coordinates. These are called coordinates. And another name of the coordinate is ordered pair. They are all ordered pair. You have to draw them, you have to plot them on the coordinate axis, and you have to write in which quadrant they are lying. Hurry up. Plot the coordinate axis. Mention x, x dash, y, y dash, and central point. Point of intersection of both the axes is called origin. Now, draw the coordinate axis. This horizontal line is called x-axis. This vertical line is called y-axis. X-x dash, y-y dash, and the point of intersection is origin. On the right side of this origin, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And on the left of this, -1, -2, -3, -4, exceed the line, write the number till 7 as we need in the question. On the upward side of this y, you have 1, 2, 3, and 4. On the downward side, you have -1, -2, -3, and -4. Now plot the points. X, this x coordinate is called abscissa. This y coordinate is called ordinate, and the combination of two is called coordinate. So x2 y minus 5 x2 and y minus 5, this is the point that will lie in the fourth quadrant. Is it clear? You haven't drawn the x2 y minus 5. Next is x minus 7, y 2. Y 2 कहाँ है? कहाँ आएगा? It's your wish whether you want to join them or no. You can directly plot the point here. Next is 4, 3. Look here. Next is 4, 3. X, 4, Y, 3. Yeah, next is minus 6, 0. In this point, Y coordinate is 0. It will lie on X axis. Where Y? X, Y. X, Y. Y coordinate is 0. So it will lie on X axis. So this is your point minus 6. X hai nahi? Kyunki minus 6 kahan hai? X ka? Minus 6, 0. Does this point lie in the quadrant? No, it will lie. Where it is lying, beta? It's visible on X axis. Next is minus 3, minus 2. X minus 3, Y minus 2. And it is lying in the which quadrant? Quadrant I am talking about. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. This point, both positive, first quadrant. X negative, Y positive, second quadrant. Both negative, third quadrant. X positive, Y negative, fourth quadrant. This point is lying in the fourth quadrant. Okay? I have written 4 more coordinates. Plot them in the same graph and check whether they are lying in the quadrant or they are lying on the axis. Hurry up. Here, y coordinate is 0, so it will lie on x axis. Here, x coordinate is 0, so it will lie on y axis. Here, both are positive, x is positive, y is positive. So it will lie in the first quadrant. Here, both are negative, so it will lie on the third quadrant. Plot same here.